Hello, good morning. An amazing morning to you, my wonderful students. How are you today? It is nice to have you back on this platform. Today we'll be considering verbs. I'll be considering the part one of verbs. I remain Dakwadi Moloye. Please sit down quietly, get writing materials, and let's get set to learn. Our learning objectives include the following. At the end of the class, you need to define verbs, you need to state what verbs are. Number two, you need to explain types of verbs based on main verbs and helping verbs. You need to give examples for them. And number four, you need to use them meaningfully in sentences. And lastly, you should be able to identify them easily. Now let's do correction to our last assignment. Last class, we considered sentence structure. And I gave you the following assignment. I said she was telling me the type of sentence stated below. Number one, the first one is a simple sentence. She completed a literature review is a simple sentence. Although she completed a literature review, she still needed to work on a method session. That's a complex sentence. Number three is a simple sentence. Number four, that is a complex compound sentence. It has two simple sentences with one or more subordinate clause. I've told you, when a sentence is compound, that is, it has two simple sentences. Now it's now compound complex. It has two simple sentences plus one or more subordinate clause. Then we have number five to be a compound sentence. Just two simple sentences only. Number six is a complex sentence, a simple sentence with a subordinate clause. And number seven is a simple sentence. Just one verb is in there. That's why it's called a simple sentence. It has one verb, one subject, and it connotes a single thought. Lovely. Let's go to the definition of verbs. Verbs like you were taught in school, taught in primary school, then they will tell you, verb is an action word, is a doing word, it indicates action, it states a process or a condition. I must tell you that it is the most important part of a sentence. It is the act of any sentence. That's a verb in a sentence. The verb, the sentence is not possible. Like I told you, it's a doing word or a word that shows action. It states event or a state. And every sentence to have must have a verb, either in the main verb form or in the helping verb form. At times, you can have it in both forms. And like I said, no sentence can be completed without a verb. That means no verb, no sentence. And like I said, it's either an action word or a doing word. There's action here. See the action here, swimming. He swims, and this is a doing word. He is president. That does not connote action. He's stating a process, stating a state of being. I told you your sentence must either have a verb, like it has here, or a verb and an helping verb. Verb and helping verb. Now let's go to types of sentences. Sorry, of verbs, rather, of verbs. We have these four major types of verbs for consideration today. We have more than this, but we'll limit ourselves to this for today. Let's start with the main verb. The main verb is called the lexical verb or the principal verb. It's the major verb because it shows action or state of being. This is why it is called a main verb. It is called a main verb because it shows action. And if you see the following sentences, let's look at them on my own. The verbs here. Real action is emphasized here. Real action is emphasized here. Real action here. Real action here. Real action here. Real action here. These are sentences with main verbs. It has been used in different forms to show real action, although some of the sentences have helping verb. But a main verb is that verb that shows real action or states a process of being. Then for a main verb, at times they can come after a helping verb. Mostly they come after a helping verb. That is if it requires a helping verb. Look at looks here. Looks is the main verb here. This is the main verb here. But this is the helping verb, the HV, helping verb. Then we have the auxiliary or helping verb, the auxiliary of helping verb. These ones are attached to the main verbs. For the main verbs to have meaning, they are attached. They come before the main verb. For the main verb to have meaning, at times they can stand on their own. Get me right? At times they can stand on their own. But most times they are attached to the main verb for the main verb to have meaning. Like I said here, the main verb can stand in front of right, like it's in front of right here, and also it can stand on its own. And we have helping verbs in this form. We have helping verbs, many helping verbs. But I'll tell you that divisions later, I'll divide them into two. There are two major parts. You have helping verbs. These are all helping verbs. Look at them very well. You can pause this video to jot them down. But we need them because you'll see them in subsequent slides. Then the first one is a primary auxiliary verb. These are primary, these ones are mostly attached to main verbs and they can stand on their own. They are used to conjugate or reflect plurality. You see it here? To conjugate or reflect plurality or tenses in main verbs. And there are three in forms. We have the be verb, the have verb, and the do verb. Let's see them one by one. We'll see them later. We'll see them later. The subsequent slides. This is another one, which is the modal auxiliary verb. This shows mood. Modal. These are verbs that show mood. They show the mood of a speaker, which can either be necessity, which can be capability, which can be willingness, which can be possibility, which can be readiness also. I am going now. I'm ready to go now. So these ones, and they are all in these forms. There are nine. There are nine. They come in these forms. Then let's see the first type of verb now. These are the helping verbs, the primary auxiliary verb, primary auxiliary verb. See, this is a B form. All these are types of verbs under the B form. Am, is, are, was, were, been. They are all types of verb under the B form. And then the do form, they are just three. Do, does, and did. From what we all know, does is the singular form, do is a plural form, and did is the past tense of both do and does. Then here we have under have verb, we have the following. As is singular, have is plural, had is a past tense form, then having is the ing form, and here also doing is the ing form here. In case, don't forget that doing is the ing form here. Then here we have the modal auxiliary verbs exemplified. You can see them. Can, that will show you ability. I can, I might, possibility, I will, willingness, I could, that is past tense, ability, I may, that is possibility, I must, that is compulsion. They all determine how the verb works. They determine, as I said, they show mood. Then let's see the mood they display here. Let's see. All these three, they fall under possibility. You can see them there. They fall under possibility. I might. Can here shows ability, shows to grant permission. Would here, it's working under something on its own. It shows passes of will. Then it's a repetitive action and it can be a conditional mood status. It can show mood in a conditional way. These are all the ways they work. These are all the ways they work, kind of things they determine. Then let's see them better here. Let's see them better here. Here we have them classified. Can and could will show ability. Can, could, and may can and could can show permission again. Then advice here should. Obligation which must be done, must and have. Possibility also, these are all the ways they show their mood and the ways they work. Then the auxiliary verb, the primary auxiliary verb, the primary auxiliary verb now, which is the first one here. I'm listing them for you again, making them bolder here. I've explained this before. I've explained this also. And I've explained this also. Then I've given you the list of modal auxiliary verbs. So let's try and note the difference that our helping verbs are in two forms. We have the primary auxiliary verb and the modal auxiliary verb. Then in conclusion, we can see the main thing here, which is a verb. Then the two forms, the lexical and the what? The auxiliary. And on lexical, we'll go to this later. When a verb is transitive, that verb takes objects. It takes an object. When it is intransitive, it doesn't take objects. Let me give you an example now. I ate rice. This is transitive. Transitive. Ate is a verb. Oh, objects. Rice is objects. Look at this. I sleep always. Object receives action. This is our verb, yes? This is not the object. This is the adverb. This is the adverb. This is intransitive. That means verbs that don't take objects are called intransitive objects. But you have these that I've explained here. This, I've explained this, auxiliary, and the modal. In next class, we'll continue with other types of verbs. Before next class, please, all these reference materials will help you further in your research on verbs. Lay your hands on them and make sure you read more about verbs from them. Till we see next class, this assignment is a must for everyone to do. You pick your right answers. Send your answers to me through my mail. My mail is on the first part of the slide. My mail is darkbo.oremoloye@greenland.org. You can send me your answers anytime. Next class, we'll do the corrections together. I want to thank you for listening to me. Keep studying, don't relent, and you'll see improvements very, very soon in the way you speak and the way you write. Thank you. I love you all.